Welcome to the Pivot Tables participation project for the WV mining problem. In this project, we're going to take a look at how we can use pivot tables and pivot charts to summarize data. To get started, I've downloaded and extracted the provided data files, and I've opened up the starter file here in Excel. Let's get started by creating a pivot table based on the data on our coal mine sheet. I'm going to use cells A3 through J58, which is essentially everything other than the total row, to form the basis of my pivot table. With those cells selected, I'm going to go to the Insert ribbon and click the Pivot Table button. The default values here in the Create Pivot Table dialog are all OK, so I'm just going to click the OK button. And you'll see here it's made this new sheet that has a pivot table on it. Before I go and configure the pivot table, I want to rename the sheet. So I'll double click on where it says sheet 1, and I'm going to call this coal mined pivot table. Working through the instructions, we're going to go and add different fields to different places. I want to add the 1999 plus top 10 county indicator as a filters field. I'm going to add the region and then the county as rows fields, and I'm just dragging these fields to these different locations that I want them to go to. And then I can drag each of these different years, or I can also go and just check their boxes, and it's going to go and add them as values fields. We want to make sure here, as we go and look at these different figures for the years, that it's going through and summing these values. And we can tell that in part because the auto-generated label here says sum of 1999, sum of 2004. Sum is one of several different statistical operations that pivot tables can be used to perform. What's going to do here is if there were, like, for example, multiple values that would go and feed into any of these labels, like all these different counties that are in the central region, it's going to sum them up now. But I can change and use a different measure by right-clicking on the column that I'm interested in, going to summarize values by, and choosing a different option. So for example, if I want to find the average, I can go through and tell it to average, and now this is the average of how much coal was mined in each of the central counties rather than the sum that I had before. In our case, the instructions tell us that we want to sum all those values. So just looking across, everything is sum. We don't need to do anything else to go and change this. I want to create a second pivot table so that I can take a different view of the information from my coal mine sheet. I'm going to head back to coal mine here, and it still has cells A3 through J58 selected. That's the cell range I want to use for this new pivot table. So I'm going to go to the Insert ribbon and just click on the Pivot Table button again. The default values in the Create Pivot Table dialog box are all right, so I will click OK, and I get a new pivot table. I want to name this sheet as 2019 Coal Mined Pivot Table, and we're going to focus just on data for 2019 here with this sheet. The instructions tell me that I should add the 2019 data as a rows field, and I want to go and add the county name as a values field. You can see that when I do that, for this first column, I get all the different amounts of coal that were mined. The second column here is counting the number of counties that have this particular amount of coal. So out of the 55 counties in West Virginia, 32 didn't mine any coal in 2019. Count is another one of the options that are available to me when I go to summarize values by. So if I'm trying to go through and see, for example, how many items fall in a particular category, creating a pivot table and using the count is a really easy way to go and get that data. But I actually want to go and consolidate things a little bit further here. I have, you know, a lot of counties that have no coal, but then I have all of these categories that just had one county inside of them. I want to group things a little bit more, just so that I can get a better quick glance of where things stand. I'm going to click in one of the cells that has the data that I'm trying to group by. So the amount of coal mined here is what I'm going to group by. When I'm clicked into this cell, I can go and right click and tell it to group. I need to tell Excel how I want it to group my numbers. These checkboxes here correspond with this auto label. If I leave these as auto, Excel will figure out where it should start grouping, what the lowest number is going to group by, and where the grouping should end on the high end. In my case, I want to start grouping at zero, and that's fine there. I'll let Excel figure out where it should finish grouping. The by option is where I tell Excel how big I want my categories to be. Excel is going to look at the values that you have, and it'll suggest a size for the by field box here. Based on the numbers that I've got, it suggested that I group these into categories of 1 million tons. But that's still going to give me more categories than I really care about. I'm going to change this so that I group by 2 million tons. I'll go ahead and click OK. And you can see that Excel has gone and collapsed things down into these different categories. So we have 39 counties that produce less than 2 million tons. And our highest category is between 18 million tons and just shy of 20 million tons here. There's one county there. It will go and omit categories that don't have any items. So that's kind of why we jump from, you know, this 6 to just shy of 8 million, and then we go up to 10 to just shy of 12 million. It, since those weren't going to have any values in them, it just left them off the list. We're going through and counting our values here. That's what we want to do in this case because we're trying to figure out how many counties go and fall into that category. So at this point, we're done with this particular pivot table. In addition to having pivot tables, which display data basically as a table, we can also create pivot charts, which give us the same type of functionality as a pivot table, but it'll go and display the value using a chart. We're going to create a pivot chart with an associated pivot table, and we want to do that based on the data from our total value sheet. Over here, we're going to select cells A3 through K58, the entirety of our table. On the insert ribbon, I'm going to go and say that I want to do a pivot chart and pivot table. So I use the little drop down menu below the pivot chart button. The pivot chart and pivot table are going to be linked. So if I go and make a change to one, it'll be reflected on the other. The default values are okay in this dialog, so I'm going to click OK. And you can see it's made this new sheet here where it has a pivot table, and then this is where the pivot chart is on this side. I'm going to leave the pivot table on this sheet, and I'm going to rename it to be Total Values Pivot Table. But I want to move the chart to its own sheet. That way it's out of the way and doesn't interfere with the pivot table. I'll right click on the pivot chart and tell it to move chart. And I'm going to put on a new sheet where I'll call it Total Values Pivot Chart. And we'll click OK there. I can go and make changes to either the pivot table or the pivot chart, and they'll be reflected on the other. If we notice here on our pivot chart pane, pivot table pane, when we're looking at the pivot table, we can see it's got the same sort of format with the fields, and then it's got these four different boxes down below. The labels vary a little bit depending if you're looking at the pivot table side of things or the pivot chart. In the instructions, we're using the labels for the pivot table. So I'm going to head over there when I go and add my fields. Instructions tell me that I should add the region as a rows field, so I'll drag that down to there. And then I'm going to add data for 1999, 2009 and 2019 as values. You can see those are showing up here on my pivot table, and if I go to my pivot chart, they're showing up there as well. We want to apply some formatting. I'm going to head back over to the pivot table first. I want to double check that we're going in summing each of these sets of values, and the fact that it says sum of tells me that we are. That part's good. But even though we're dealing with dollar amounts, this doesn't really look like a dollar amount. I want to go and format these as currency with no decimal places. There's different ways I can do it. I don't want to just select my cells and go to the format cells dialog, because if I go and change something with that pivot table, if I go and maybe, you know, add counties instead of just the regions, it's going to break my formatting. I'd have to go back and reformat it. What I want to do is I want to use number formatting options that are tied to these specific fields that I'm going through and showing here. I'm going to start off by using the 1999 values, and I'm going to show you two different ways we can go and set things up. The first one would be to go and just right click inside of the column that I'm trying to format. So I want to do 1999 here. I want to go to the number format option that shows up. Here I can tell it that I want to do currency and I want zero decimal places. I'll go ahead and tell it OK. It's going to go and format that column. The other way, the little bit older way, is to go down onto our pivot tables pane, and I want to format sum of 2009. So where it has that listing there, I can click the down arrow and I'm going to go into value field settings. Here is another place where we can actually change how it's going to summarize things by, but I want to go into number format. And this is going to be the same dialog box that I got through the right click earlier. We'll tell it I want to do currency with no decimal places. And we'll click OK to get back out of there. And then I need to format the 2019 values as well. So for this one, I'll do the more direct route. Just right click and go to number format. Just decimal places and tell it OK. No matter how I go and change stuff, you know, if I were to go through and add county, it's still going to go through and format these as currency, no matter what I do. Whereas if I had just right-clicked and gone directly into format cells, I would have to go back and reapply those settings. Let's go over to our pivot chart and apply some formatting there. You can see that it picked up the currency formatting from the pivot table, so that part's been cleaned up. But we need to do a little bit of additional stuff. First thing we want to do is double check that we have the right chart type. And I can kind of eyeball to see this, but if I go and right click and tell it to change chart type, I can verify that this is a clustered column chart and these are 2D bars. They're not 3D like we would see here. So we have the right chart type. I do need to go and label my chart though. So I'm going to go to the green plus sign here, and I'm going to check the box for axis titles and also check for a chart title. So let's go and title this chart just by clicking in where it says chart title, and we'll do value of coal mined by region. For our vertical axis here, let's call this value of coal mined. And for the horizontal axis, we'll label this as region. So we've got this chart taken care of, and we've done with the pivot table, so this piece is ready to go. Another nice feature from pivot tables and pivot charts is that we can easily update them if the underlying data changes. You know, I could go through and calculate statistics similar to what we had here for the coal mined pivot table. If I did it manually and one of these numbers needed to change, it would be a bit of work to go through and update it every place. But with pivot tables, I just have to tell it to go and refresh my data. let's see how this works. I'm going to go head over to the source for this data. That's on our coal mine sheet. If I look in cell C5, Berkeley County mined no coal in 1999. I'm going to go and change this to say that they mined 150,000 tons. So we'll enter 150,000. I hit enter there. Let's go back and take a look at the coal mined pivot table. And in the eastern panhandle, we can see that Berkeley County still says zero because that's what the value was when it loaded this data. If I go and right click though, I can tell it to refresh. And it's going to go and check and update these values based on what's happened to my data. So now, since we said that there were 150,000 tons mined, when I go and refresh the data, I get that we have 150,000 tons mined. So if I update statistics, I just need to make sure that I go to my pivot tables or pivot charts and right click and refresh them, and that'll pull the most recent data. I'm gonna head back to my table and I'll set Berkeley County back to being zero. And then I'm gonna refresh my pivot table again just so that we have the correct statistics as we go forward. Let's finish up this project by answering the analysis question. We'll go over to the analysis question sheet, and we're going to specify that we are answering question 7C. The prompt for this question says that between 1950 and 2010, coal mine employment in West Virginia fell from about 113,000 to 14,000, yet the amount of coal produced went up, and we're asked, how can this be the case? Well, obviously something changed that allowed each coal miner to become way more productive. And what's generally going to allow somebody to become more productive? They get machines that can go through and do some of the work. And that's what happened in the coal mining industry. After World War II, you saw a lot of mechanization in the mines. Jobs that people would go and do by hand before, they got machines to do them. And they essentially used those machines to go and replace people. That's why they're able to produce more coal now, even though they have just a fraction of the number of workers. So let's go ahead and write an answer for this one here. Mechanization allowed each worker to become much more productive by having machines do work rather than completing tasks by hand. Each miner is able to get much more done and mine more coal. So, simple answer, straight into the point. That's all that it is in this particular participation project. You'll want to go and save your file, close out of Excel, and then submit the assignment.